made the decision. But at the bottom of all of that stuff was we have something musically that we can achieve.
It was not easy for John. I don't think it was easy for Chris either, but just as a man, I saw a lot of pain for John.
And now, we are as good friends as ever. But at that moment, you know, it was awful. You know, 'cause you're told by someone that you adore and love, and still do, that I don't want you in my life anymore. The bottom line was, this is what we do, we make music, and accept this as an unfortunate situation.
One of the hard things was to see John so sad. I mean, we actually didn't talk at all. John and I did not talk. Stevie and Lindy didn't get on very well either, but they used to fight, you know, whereas John and I used to just avoid each other. They used to fight, although not all the time. They could, in actual fact, get on quite well, especially when they were writing songs together. John and I did not write songs together, and we did not talk, period. Except for the civilities in life, like what key is this song in, you know. That would be more or less it. And so we just spent 6 months in that studio avoiding each other.
At that time, it was at the record plant Sausalito, which was the beginning, I'd say actually mid-70s, which was a unique time in Sausalito anyway. It was just, the end of the hippie movement, and there was a lot of drugs flying around and far-out people, and things were not based on reality in that town anyway. And here's the record plant, you know, situated right in the middle of all this. The record plant back then was all wood and dark. I guess somewhat good for creating, but we never saw, there's no windows in this place. We never saw the sun. I didn't know what time of day it was half the time. I know everybody really bitched about it at first. Everybody wanted to stay in their own homes and be comfortable. And I believe Mick was very insistent about taking everybody out of that environment so that we would have nobody to count on but ourselves.
Strange to think that the last time I saw you in this room was like 21 years ago.
Yes.
Wow.
Glad you survived it.
Thanks. Glad you did too.
So yeah, we all made it.
You too, Ken.
We all made it, didn't we?
It's great to see you. Mm-hmm. It really is.
We really wondered whether or not we would get through Rumours. Again, you know, in this studio, in that room in there, in that tiny little room, there was, you know, five people that were totally breaking up.
Whatever was going on in the band, specifically between the two couples, very much informed the material. And I think that was a very great appeal of the album. If you look at the success that Rumours enjoyed, I think that it goes a little bit beyond the music itself. I think a resonance kicks in that has to do with the interaction of the people, the whole being greater than the sum of the parts. And I think a tangible element of that is the fact that you had these dialogues shooting back and forth between members of the band about things that were happening to all of us while we were recording these songs.
Thunder only happens when it's raining. Love you when they're playing. They say women, they will come and they will go. When the rain washes you clean, you know.
Dreams was written on one of those nights where there wasn't anything for me to do. So I went down the hall to a studio that was here in the record plant, that was Sly Stone's studio, And when I had nothing to do, I could take all my stuff down there. And so I would take a electric piano with me and, you know, my crocheting and my journals and my books and my art. And I'd just kind of just stay there, you know, until they needed me. So one day, sitting in Sly Stone's bed with this big black curtained bed, fabulous, you know, totally. It wasn't my room, so it could be fabulous. It was somebody else's room. I just went in there one afternoon and wrote Dreams, and it was, and I knew when I wrote it that it was really special, and I was really not self-conscious or insecure about showing it to the rest of the band. I knew they were going to really like it.
This is pretty much what it sounded like in the first few days of working on it. Once again, John would be, you can recognize that bass line anywhere. There you go, signature John McVie, Fleetwood bass drum line.
It's always difficult to give your song to somebody and know that they're going to take it to places you can't take it, because they, you know, play guitar and piano and arrange music, you know. If they do a good job, then it's great, you know. If they don't, then it's not great. Then you wish you hadn't given it up. Or you wish you'd been more involved, or you'd wish you'd been there more, you know, or something goes wrong. Lindsay had an amazing way of taking my songs and making them wonderful. When he was happy with me.
When we mix these songs, we usually look for the heart and soul of a song, and we kind of tear this mix down in different areas and see what worked, what didn't work, and what did we build the song around. And you can see right there, it's pretty well the core of the song.
Whatever Stevie's music was, somehow I was this soulmate that just knew exactly what to do with it. And that never went away. It just became a little bittersweet in terms of wanting to do it. There were times when I had the urge not to want to help her. And that's a weird thing to admit, but these were the challenging things.
Great example of the band just pulling it together. Stevie and Lindsay, when they were solo, lived together, and Stevie could wrap her voice around Lindsay's so well. He'd do harmonies with her, she'd do harmonies with him. It was really a great blend. When they joined Fleetwood Mac, Christine came in, and the three of them created the sound. It was amazing. And it was even more amazing for me because they oftentimes had to sing on one microphone or on three microphones in a small room, looking at each other, and you can imagine the turmoil they were going through when all these relationships were breaking up. And through all the turmoil, they'd come out with vocals that sound like this.
Oh, thunder only happens when it's raining.
What we have here is Chris and Lindsay doing the main lead vocal, and Stevie doing two harmonies.